Good morning, thanks for tuning in. Welcome to a new trading day, which will see the local share market kick off well in positive territory. The futures are telling us that the ASX 200 will be up by 0.8% when trade gets underway later on this morning. So that comes after the SPY contract gained 52 points in after hours trade. It equally reflects a constructive session as far as Wall Street in particular was concerned, because it was there that we saw the main event of the week come to pass in the US Federal Reserve's decision on rates. They left rates on hold as widely expected. So Fed funds in that range of 5.25% to 5.5%. But it was the messaging that was associated with that decision that was important. So to that end, they navigated that delicate path between describing the fortunes of the US economy most recently, which have been quite solid, and then to the same end, managing that conversation around inflation not being quite where it needs to be and the possibility of having to raise rates again. So all of those elements seem to be in balance in terms of the way that the markets responded. We saw stocks do well. It was the most interest rate sensitive parts of the stock market that did well last night. The technology names, the NASDAQ up 1.6%. The broader market, the S&P 500, rose by just over 1%, and the Dow Jones was up by around 0.75%. There was another important component in terms of the price moves as well that was reassuring to investors broadly. And of course, that was what we saw where interest rate markets were concerned. So to that end, we saw a significant drop in 2- and 10-year government bonds in yield terms. So the yield on a 10-year was down by 11 basis points. The yield on a 2-year Treasury note was down by 11 basis points as well. So the important part to note about that is that that move lower in government bond yields wasn't just a reflection of what we saw with the US Federal Reserve. It was also a reflection of the fact that the refunding needs of the US Treasury have been trimmed. And it also goes hand in glove with a recent reporting of conversations that the Treasury Borrowing Advisory Committee. So this is a group of private institutions. It's an outreach conversation basically with the US Treasury. They has been reported expressed the need of the US Treasury to be more disciplined in terms of spending generally, and the fact that the borrowing requirement for the next quarter was reined in a little bit, that was seen as a positive as well. So that contributed to that fall where interest rates were concerned. It was, apart from that, a busy day elsewhere as far as corporate earnings have been concerned. So one of the big movers in the tech space last night was Advanced Micro Devices. That stock up by about 12%, having reported its quarterly earnings, which bettered expectations on the top and bottom line. So earnings per share came in at 70 cents per share. They were looking for 64 in terms of the analysts. The revenue measure came in at 5.8 billion for the quarter. So that was well above the 5.46 that the market was looking for. The guidance was upgraded and was substantially higher than what the market was looking for. That spoke to accelerating sales growth, which is expected over the course of the full year. So that all came home to roost for the share price, which, as I said, was up very smartly by 12%. Garmin was another organization with a similar improvement. The shares up by about 11%. There were a host of positives reflected in their earnings. So most of their business segments doing very well. Watch sales over the quarter up by about 26%. They raised their full year guidance. Their revenue bettered expectations by a considerable margin, coming in at $1.23 billion. The market was looking for $1.2 billion. Elsewhere, their free cash flow was much stronger than expected over the course of the quarter at $312 million. And combine that with their already substantial cash position of about $2.8 billion, it really underwrites the dividend that they're currently paying out in the market. Liked all of that, and that's why the shares did as well as they enjoyed last night. And then, of course, we have got Apple, which will be reporting in the next day as well. So Apple shares a little bit firmer ahead of important and widely anticipated earnings numbers, which will be delivered in the next day, as I said. So on the local front today, we have got a positive day in prospect, as I said. In terms of company results, we have got CSR reporting earnings. We've also got the Star Entertainment Group convening an annual general meeting. Economic news sees housing finance and trade balance numbers reported. None of those will take your breath away in any sort of meaningful way, but nonetheless, they will be on the calendar. As far as the Aussie dollar is concerned. So it has been a beneficiary of a moderating US dollar, it must be said. It was a bit bouncy after the Fed decision. The local unit trading back to around 63.7 US cents, but now it's threatening that 64 US cent mark. So not only that, but in addition to the expectation that the RBA will be raising rates next week, that has all been quite supportive for the currency, in addition to the recent increase where iron ore prices have been concerned as well at the margins. That's been supportive for the Aussie dollar. So thanks for tuning in this morning. Have a great day.